A very good morning, students. Today we will study second part of the lotus eaters. As I have told you, in the first part, Ulysses or Odysseus and his fellow mariners come to an island which belonged to lotus eaters. They reached that island, and as soon as they come, the inhabitants of that land give them lotus, and as soon as they tasted those fruits, they become very drowsy, and they started talking that they have no desire to return to their homeland, and they will remain there. Now, in the second part, they give reason after reason why they want to stay there till the end of their life. This incident is given in the chorus song, and they all of them begin together and started singing the song, and in that particular song they decide not to return, and they give reason after reason that why they don't want to return their home. So I'll just read out and then try to explain to all of you. There is sweet music here and soft falls, then petals from blonde roses on the grass, or night dew on still waters between walls of shadowy granite in a gleaming past. What a beautiful language are. There is sweet music here. In this place, on this island, there is a sweet music that soft falls, that falls on ear more softer than petals from blown roses on the grass. Is there any sound when a petal falls on grass? No, there is no sound. So music is coming more sweetly on their ears, as softer, more softer than a petal fall on the grass. Second image, or night dew on still water between walls of shadowy granite in a gleaming past. Or night dew, as dew falls on still water on water between walls on stored water of shadowy granite in a gleaming past. So when the dew falls, it makes no sound. So the music on their ear is falling more sweetly, more softer than these two things. Then in the next music that gentlier on the street lies, then tired eyelid upon tired eyes. But only and only tradition can write some kind of lines. Music that gentlier on the street lies. Music that is more gentlier on street lies on the music. This is very soft music. Then tired eyelid upon tired eyes. As this eyelid falls, tired eyelid falls on tired eyes. Music fall more gently on the street lies. Who are the street lies? These mariners. So music is coming to their ears more gently than a tired eyelid falls on tired eyes. Music that brings sweet sleep down from the blissful sky. This music is more sweet, brings sweet sleep down from the blissful sky. Blissful sky in heavens. This music is so sweet that it brings sweet sleep from that heaven. Here are cool voices deep, and through the nose the ivy grew, and in the stream of long limbed flower weep, and from the craggy lair the poppy hangs in sleep. Here are cool voices deep. There are cool voices. On this place there are cool, deep cool voices, and through the nose the ivy creep. There are ivies which are creeping, and in the stream the long limbed flower weep. In the stream there are plants which have long leaves, and from the crazy lairs the poppy hanging sleep. Poppy hanging sleep, again the use of transferred epithet. Poppy is not hanging sleep, but the persons who are picking that poppy, they are in sleep. So the whole atmosphere of this island is full of drowsiness and sleepy. So the second half of the poem is made of this poetic stanza. In this, Ulysses and his crew describe the safety and comfort of the land of the lotus eaters and the lack of their desire not to return. So in the this stanza, the men being men begin to sitting, and this land is full of music that falls softly. It is sound resembled to the petals of roses blowing onto the grass, or perhaps it seems night dews that softly collect on the still waters. They continue piling up to metaphor after metaphor and state that it is gentle than the feeling of closing one's eyes when one is tired. It brings joy to them that is like sweet sleep falling upon from the blissful sky. They have everything that they could want. The earth is made from cool mosses and is worn with ivies. The beautiful unity of plants is complemented by streams that hold flower and the craggy lanes which play host of poppies. The world around them resembles their own interior feeling. They are seeing their own inner peace reflected in plants, streams, and one another. So the whole atmosphere is atmosphere of drowsiness, of sleepiness. As we know, these tired mariners are tired from their 10 years journey in the sea. So even these things resemble their interior feelings. They saw everything, whatever is going on in their minds, now they feel in this place. Now the second thing. Now they give another reason for staying in this place. Why we weighed upon the heavy, upon with heaviness, and utterly consumed with sharp distress, while all things else have rest from weariness, all things have rest, why should we toil alone? Now they are giving reasons that why we are weighed upon this heaviness, why we people, we human beings are burdened, having this heaviness, and utterly consumed with sharp distress. Why we people are consumed with sharp distresses of life's agony, while all things else have rest from weariness. Everything in nature have some rest from their exhaust from their weariness. All things have rest. Everything have rest. Why should we do that alone? Why should we when we should worry? Why should we when we make hard work, except everything in nature is having rest. And we only toil who are first of things. We human beings only make hard work, and we are topmost of the things. We are first of things and make perpetual work. And even making hard work, we always make a continuous, perpetual, continuous work in suffering agony. So, after having that hard working, we just get habitual mode, continuous sufferings, still from one sorrow to another throne. We are thrown from one sorrow to another, one difficulty to another, one agony to another. Nor ever hold our wings. To hold wings means to have rest. We never rest and cease from wandering. And we never cease from wandering. We never stop from wandering. So we should have some rest from wandering. Nor sleep, nor brown in slumber's holy one, nor hearken with inner sweet sense. There is no joy but calm. Why should we toil the root of the crown of peace? Now they give another reason. Nor sleep or browse in slumber's holy one. Mean we never take a good sleep. Nor hearken intuition, nor hearken what the inner spirit sees, whatever our inner spirit, whatever our inner soul is saying, we never hear the voice of our soul. There is no joy but calm. But calm. What our inner spirit is saying, what our inner soul is saying, that there is no joy but calm. the car, the peace is only in having rest. Why should we toil and why should we make a hard work? Who? We human beings who are the roof and crown of things, who are the supreme of all things. So why should we have rest? So the second part of choral song follow a particular theme of discontent. They are not satisfied. Their narrator speaking from the man asked the universe why men have no rest while all others do. They state that they are weighed upon with heavy distress while also being consumed with sharp distress. The man do not believe that this is fair as everything else in the world have rest. Why should there be the only creatures who consistently toil again? Why should only human beings toil alone? As was found in the first part of the poem, men after eating the lotus fruit are only concerned with their own well-being. They no longer feel for those beyond their reach. The first of things, they have only one to toil and only to make ritual moan. The men are rejecting their previous lives of hard work and struggle in favor of one in which they will only rest. They have no longer want to turn their sorrow to sorrow, nor ever have a stop doing as they please in favor of working. So these mariners are now totally rebelled against working, and they want completely a rest for forever. Now come to the third stanza. Again, they will give some another kind of reasons for their staying there, for their note making journey. Lo, in the middle of the wood, the folded leaf is moved from out of the bud, with wings upon the branch, and there grows green and broad, and takes no care. Sun escaped at noon, and in the moon. Nighty dew fade and turning yellow falls flowers adown the air. Listen, in the middle of the wood, middle of the forest, jungle, forest. Look, in the middle of wood, the folded leaf is moved from out of bud. As we have seen that from the bud, a leaf is constructed and in making, in being from bud to leaf, there is no hard labor. With wings upon the branch, and there grow green and broad and take no care. And with the wind upon the branch, and there grows green and broad, a leaf become green and become broad also, and takes no care. There is no care also. It takes no care. And then what happens? Sun escaped and moon, and in the moon nighty dew fed. Sun comes and give food to it, and in the night moon comes and give dew in form of food. Nighty dew fed and turning yellow, and after getting its life it turned yellow and floats down the air, and by the air it's fall down. A life circle of a leaf becomes complete. In the next. So, having from birth to death, a leaf is not making any toil. In the next region, lo, sweetened with the summer light, the cool juiced apple waxing or mellow, drop in silent autumn night. Another thing, listen, sweetened with the summer light, an apple becomes sweetened with the summer light, the cool juiced apple. It becomes fully juiced, filled with the juice, waxing or mellow, drop in silent autumn night, and ultimately it drops in a night of autumn. All its attained length of day, everything is given a certain length of days. The flower ripen in its place, flower automatically ripe on their certain place, ripen and fades, flower ripes and ultimately fades. Wither and falls, ultimately fall and hath no toil. And in this way. They have not to make any hard work, fast rooted in the fruitful soil. Even these plants are fast rooted in fruitful land, fruitful soil. So ultimately, they have not to do anything. So the third of these, third stanza of these choric songs, this tells us on how the men feel that unlike the rest of creation, they are unable to have peaceful life that consists of living and then dying. They want to live as a leaf does, budding, being blown on a branch, growfully green and broad, never having to take care, and then finally after being dew-fed under the moon and then turning yellow and turns to the ground, they are seeing the life circle of the simplest part of creation as the most appealing to them. All things, the chorus states later, are able to live to an allotted length of days and then be replaced by something else that will eventually ripen and fade. These lives are the most fulfilling as they have a distinct purpose that does not include toiling. So they give reason that they also only they have to make toil, they have to hard work, everything in nature is not making any hard toil. So we will also not make any toil, we will not also make any hard work and stay there throughout the year life. So this is given in these three stanzas. Okay, for today it is enough. So have a good day. Thank you.